he did not get up and walk out of here. Guy's at death's door.
Tell me you did not misplace my patient.
I went to check the urine output in 105.2. It was only gone a minute. Palliative care? Social work found a hospice, if he lasts that long.
No family. No insurance.
Check the morgue.
You know, there is such a thing as harvesting organs and trafficking in cadavers, or such is the public perception. Let's not play into that.
Got him. Celestial discharge at 9:15.
Okay, my patient expires, and nobody pages me.
Wait, morgue says body never got there. Give us a few minutes.
Track him down before your shift change so that I can go home.
Okay, thanks. We got trouble. Transportation never picked him up.
Who is that? Who is she? Dan, Dan.
This nice lady seems to have made a wrong turn.
Sure, right. Ma'am, if you could come this way.
Get away from me.
Yeah, all right, okay. This area is off limits. I'm sorry, but we're at a critical phase in a very dangerous experiment,
so... You have my patient. Show him to me, or I call campus police. And then the department chair.
That would be me. Marjorie Kane, chair of the Graduate School of Neuroscience.
You're in charge?
Yes. Dr. Emma Holloway. Mm-hmm. So, regarding your patient, perhaps we could allay your fears by showing you our grand experiment.
So what we've done is we've surrounded this chamber. Every type of detection device we could think of. Air pressure, motion, light sensors, ultraviolet, infrared, all spectra.
Temperature
to a hundredth of a centigrade, actually. An electric grid to a fraction of a millivolt. Magnetic, electromagnetic. On the quantum level, we've constructed an atomic net, exactly one particle thick, right? So if anything passes through it, anything, be it strange or charmed or up or down or backwards, it'll create a wave pattern, a measurable disturbance.
The room is a vault, not of steel, but of detection.
Mm-hmm. I'm happy for you. Now, my patient.
Dr. Holloway, tonight, in this very room, we intend to verify empirically, in the human species, the existence of a soul. Nature does not know extinction. All it knows is transformation. And everything that science has taught me and continues to teach me strengthens my belief in the continuity of our spiritual existence after death. Nothing disappears without a trace.
Soul.
Yes. You clinicians don't have a monopoly on the spiritual element.
As in Faustian bargain.
As in Jesus died to save it.
And for this, you steal a corpse?
Doctor, your patient is not deceased. Not yet.
We got a live one. Not by much.
We need to transport this patient back to ICU immediately.
George Lockwood, 73. History of portal hypertension, cirrhosis secondary to chronic alcohol abuse, presented with ascites and jaundice. Status post massive hemorrhagic stroke.
DNR. He's not expected to survive the night.
DNR does not imply consent for an experimental study. He's obtunded. He could not have given consent.
Right now, our gentle Mr. Lockwood would be lying in a hospital ward alone and waiting to die. And so a lost man in a small hospital in a city of no consequence passes on, as have millions before him and millions will after. An underpaid, overworked nurse makes a notation on his chart and his body is discarded with the morning trash. But here, his death can have meaning. No, he did not give consent for the study.
Mr. Lockwood, can you hear me?
Doctor, it's not like we can ask for volunteers.
Don't take the moral high ground, Holloway. If he coded, you wouldn't intubate. Aren't you curious? Let's see what happens.
I want a steroid drip to decrease intracranial pressure. Morphine for pain.
Entering.
All right, guys, let's fire it up.
You're not troubled by this?
No. Actually, I think we ought to spend more time on things like this. Death, life, what came before, what comes after. It's basic.
So die already.
There is no real moment of death. It's a legal construct, something to put down on a form. Long after the heart has stopped, we can still detect pulseless electrical activity. Moment of death. It's a fiction.
Till tonight, the true moment of death is when the soul leaves the body.
Spark of the divine on its journey home.
So where do you put your money, Doctor? When cerebral blood flow is inadequate to support synaptic function? Or when the reticular formation shuts down? Will the soul exit the body all at once? Or will it seep away like sand, you know?
Is that it?
It's decerebrate posturing. Primitive response common in brain injury.
Oh, here we go, here we go, here we go.
This is it, guys.
All right. Fundamental question of human existence, soon we're gonna know.
And this is a good thing. There is such a concept as faith, you know?
Faith. You've done some of the things I've done. You start dancing towards the edge of the abyss. You hunger for something a little bit more substantial than faith.
Na 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 na. Na 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 na.
Hey. Amen.
Anything?
Slight shift in the weight of the gurney. It's within tolerance.
What happened?
What is it?
There. Right there.
What do you see?
That!
No, what is that to say?
There's nothing there, Will.
Oh, my God. He's right there. He's right there. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. He's trapped. You've trapped him. You have to let him go.
You're tormenting him.
Okay, you might disagree with what we're doing here, that's fine. But the whole performance with the
It's a pretty good performance.
Yeah. We're gonna shut the grid down after 1 hour, one field at a time, as per our protocols.
You think I'm hallucinating? Or lying?
You don't
believe me?
Look, you're asking a lot, Doctor. I mean, you're claiming that you can see something the rest of us can't, that somehow your eyes are special or different, or I don't even know, that certain photons hit your retina but not ours. I mean, I'm sorry, no, I don't.
You put all those sensors all around the room. Now think about it. What is the perfect device for your search?
You're gonna say a human being, right? A human being.
My observations are data as valid as any. Oh, my God.
Is it localized?
Yeah, northeast corner.
What the hell?
No.
Yeah, the moon is inward, not outward.
Get in.
Oh my God, this is so much bigger than we thought. The hand of God reaching down to collect a wayward soul.
Not the hand of God. That's not the hand of God. He is trapped. He's hanging there like bait, and something has come.
Pleased to meet you. Won't you guess my name?
Look, it's almost there. It's almost there. There. It's inside.
Go get her, run!
She never told us that.
It's all right. It's all right. He made it. I saw it.
All right. Well, what about the next patient and the one after that?
What?
I can feel it.
What?
In my body, I can. You can't feel that?
No. I want to.
Whatever caused the disturbance is manifesting itself. You felt that, right?
Maybe, I don't know. The doctor kind of freaked me out.
Dan, you felt it. You felt it. Describe it. Just give me one word. Give me one word.
Evil.
Yeah, I was gonna say malevolent.
It's still here. I still feel it.
All right, maybe when the fields dropped, something got in, and then when we brought them back up.
We trapped it.
Trapped what?
Robbins, unlock the door. I want in.
All right,
I want in.
I don't. Dr. Holloway, do you see anything in there?
I have to go in there. I have to know.
I know, just tell me, is there anything in there? Is there anything there?
No.
nothing in there. Go ahead, open it.